This is a tutorial on how to run between subjects two-way analysis of variance in JASP. So this is our data set. But before we analyze, let's first take a look at our problem. So this is our problem. In an experiment, high and low self-esteem subjects did a puzzle task either alone or with an audience, and because of that the presence or absence of an audience is a between subjects independent variable. Likewise, self-esteem is a between subjects variable. Which levels are high self-esteem and low self-esteem? Under the assumption that self-esteem is a stable trait or disposition of an individual. And then using the data that we have, we are tasked to determine if self-esteem influences the number of committed errors in the puzzle task, as well as the presence and absence of an audience. And likewise, we will test whether audience is a moderator for the relationship between self-esteem and the number of committed errors. So we will try to answer three hypotheses here, one pertaining to this main effect, the influence of audience on the number of committed errors, as well as the influence of self-esteem on the number of committed errors, self-esteem being our primary independent variable. And finally, we will also examine whether audience moderates the relationship between self-esteem and the number of committed errors. We are hypothesizing that those who have high self-esteem, or those who have low self-esteem rather, will commit more errors compared to those with high self-esteem. We are also hypothesizing that those who perform with an audience will commit more errors compared to those who will perform the puzzle task without an audience. And finally, for the moderation, we are predicting that those who are low self-esteem will commit more errors compared to those high self-esteem, especially when there is an audience. However, we are anticipating that there will be no difference in the number of committed errors between these two groups when they perform the task privately. So this is our data set. Because this is a between subjects two-way analysis of variance, you will notice that our data is entered this way. Our column headers refer to our variables. We have two independent variables or two factors and one dependent variable, the number of committed errors. And these are the variations. So we have the high self-esteem group, the low self-esteem group, those who perform without an audience, and those who performed with an audience. And these are their respective number of committed errors under these four different conditions. Okay, so to run two-way analysis of variance, let's click on ANOVA, and then let's choose ANOVA. Our dependent variable is the number of committed errors, and our fixed factor are self-esteem and audience. Okay, so we have a couple of output here. First, we have our ANOVA result. So for the question, does self-esteem have an influence on the number of committed errors, or will there be a significant difference in the number of committed errors between those who have low and high self-esteem? Our p-value suggests that yes, there will be a significant difference in the number of committed errors. For the question, will there be a significant difference in the number of committed errors between those who perform the task with an audience and without an audience, the answer likewise is yes. There is a significant difference. So these are our two main effects. And finally, this term here, which we call as the interaction term, so this is the interaction between self-esteem and audience. This statistic is our evidence for the existence of the moderation and the ANOVA result, given that it's also below our alpha level of 0.05, this suggests that we have a significant interaction. Of course, from this output, we do not know yet the nature of that interaction, if it did really satisfy our predictions that we made early on. So to examine that, let's take a look at other output. First, let's go to additional options and let's click on estimates of effect size. We will be using the default effect size measure, which is the eta squared. And these are your measures of effect size. So self-esteem seems to be, or the number of committed errors, its variance seems to be, self-esteem seems to be explaining 31.8% of the variation in the number of committed errors. So thus, audience, and for the interaction, it is explaining 7.9% of the variation in the number of committed errors. Next, we want to see, when we say that there is a significant difference in the number of committed errors between those who have high and low self-esteem, who exactly performed worse. So in the marginal means, let's transfer self-esteem to the other side. And we can see here from the marginal means that those who have lower self-esteem committed more errors than those who have high self-esteem. So that means to say that those who committed, or those who with low self-esteem, significantly committed more errors in the puzzle task compared to those who have high self-esteem. As for the audience, our ANOVA also detected a significant difference. But what kind of significant difference? Let's also check for the marginal means. So let's enter it there. And in this case, those who performed with an audience committed more errors compared to those who performed privately. Again, supporting the hypothesis that we have forwarded early on. Okay. Next, we also want to see, because we have a significant moderation here, and specifically, we suggested that our main independent variable is self-esteem, whereas our moderator is audience. Therefore, we are assuming that this significant relationship should vary across the different levels of self-esteem. But before I go to that, I forgot to tell you something else. If ever that any of your independent variables have more than two levels, of course you have to run your post hoc test, and this is where you run your post hoc test. However, in this case, a post hoc test is not necessary, because for both our independent variables, fixed factors, we only have two levels each, and so a post hoc test will not be necessary. But hypothetically, if these levels were to be high, average, and low, then we would need to run a post hoc test for self-esteem, but not for audience. Again, we will not do this because the levels of self-esteem that we have is only high and low, only two categories. Okay, so let's go back to additional options. So let us take a look at, I was saying a while ago that essentially what we want to do is to examine separately the influence of self-esteem on the number of committed errors. One, when there is an audience, and second, when there is no audience. There are two ways to look at the descriptives. One would be to check for the marginal means, and when we do that, these are our means. When there is an audience, with an audience, the comparison between high and low self-esteem is this: 6 versus 12, which, as I've said in the lecture, seems to be a large difference, a difference of 6 points. But when there is no audience, the difference between in the number of committed errors between high self-esteem and low self-esteem is much closer, 4 and 6, a difference of 2. We can also click on descriptive statistics, and it will practically show you the same thing. So under the first level of our moderator, with an audience, the comparison between high and low is 6 and 12, but when there is no audience, the comparison between high and low is 4 and 6. So what we want to ask, we already know that there is a moderation that is going on, but we want further evidence that indeed there is a significant difference between 6 and 12, and we are anticipating that there is no significant difference between 4 and 6. So to do that, we go to our simple main effects. In our simple main effects, we are asked to enter our simple effect factor, that is our primary independent variable, and that is self-esteem. And then we are also asked to enter our moderator, which is audience. And this gives you a test of difference between high and low self-esteem under two different conditions. So with an audience, the result suggests that the p-value is less than 0.001. This suggests that the difference between 6 and 12 is significantly different with an audience, the comparison between high and low self-esteem. But without an audience, the comparison between high and low self-esteem, their number of committed errors, 4 and 6, is that significantly different? The answer is our p-value is greater than 0.05, so there is no statistical difference between 4 and 6. And finally, we can take a look at the descriptive plots. So for the descriptive plots, the way to do this is your main independent variable goes to the horizontal axis while your moderator goes to the separate lines. And of course, we have to visualize as well the error bars. Okay, so this is our comparison. So this graph is very typical of an interaction. When there is no interaction, you'd expect that these two lines are parallel with one another, meaning to say that on both levels of the moderator, the effect of the independent variable on the dependent variable is the same. But in this case, we see that it is different, the effect. So this line represent the without audience condition, and this line represent the with audience condition. For the with, when there is no audience, when the task is performed privately, The difference in the number of committed errors between high and low self-esteem is this. And you can see a lot of overlap in the confidence interval, and thus this is not significantly different, as evidenced as well by our p-value. But when there is an audience, the difference in the number of committed errors among those who have high and low self-esteem is this. Those who have low self-esteem committing more errors compared to those high self-esteem participants. And we can see that the confidence interval is not overlapping, and hence our p-value is significant. So this is a there is a significant difference here, while there is no significant difference here. So in summary, the influence of self-esteem on the number of committed errors differs when there is no audience. When there is no audience, self-esteem doesn't seem to have much of an impact. But when there is an audience, the impact of self-esteem is much more evident. Okay, so that is how you run two-way analysis of variance. Before I end this, I think I forgot to mention that you can also check some of the more important assumptions, particularly the homogeneity test, which is the test of equality of variance, which practically is just a Levine's test. And what we want for this p-value is for it to be not significant. And if this p-value is not significant, that means to say that there are no significant differences in the variance of our data. Hence, equality of variance. All right. So that sums up how you run two-way analysis of variance using JASP. If you have questions, please comment. And I hope that you learned something today, and I will see you in the next video.